Great, I got it. Welcome back, and I'm back on set today building another version of a see-through model rocket engine that I built for a previous episode, where I just cut the model rocket engine right in half. I mount it to a piece of high temperature acrylic, film it in slow motion, and the idea behind that was to show you how the model rocket engine works internally. I realized halfway in that episode that I should probably make a proper engine. So this time I'm gonna go with my original plan and I'm gonna make an entirely see-through model rocket engine properly. And our main components are gonna be this C67 rocket engine and the piece of laboratory grade glass tubing. The idea is that simple. Get this model rocket engine inside of this tube. So what's the difficult part? Well, that's another story. Now machined the cardboard casing on a rocket. Perfect, right there, 0.495. Now that I have the core component of my see-through model rocket engine done, I'm left with one problem, and that is this mess of powdered model rocket fuel left over. I have to figure out a way to clean this up, and I think I'm gonna burn it. Yeah, let's burn it. Here we go. Only got one shot at this. Let's clean up this lathe. Oh, that was cool. Smells good. I want to interrupt the programming to talk about something really quickly. I saw a few YouTube videos on how to cut glass tubing, and I was perplexed by the whole thing. These guys are setting up all these crazy rigs and spending all this money, especially when they're building, they cut glass tubing a lot when they're building like PC water cooling systems. I just want to show you really quick, if you ever want to cut glass tubing, really easy and simple. You just get one of these cheap tile saws right here. If you buy one of these are really cheap. They cut the tube, no problem. So back to our programming. That's how it leaves it right there. And here's the fuel. It was quite a lot of work to make this fit perfectly right inside that tube. And I mean, it doesn't even leak air. Here, check this out. Like, it's perfectly sealed in there. Now I have my fully functional, fully transparent, see-through model rocket engine done. And in my opinion, I think it came out pretty awesome. You can clearly see the nozzle, the main stage, and the ejection stage of the rocket. And I think this thing is gonna look just awesome. So now I just gotta get it set up and ready to fire. From the last burn, the wire from the igniter actually got soldered onto the wire. Godspeed, see-through model rocket engine. I'm really happy that my see-through model rocket engine was a success. The footage looked phenomenal. The thing worked great, better than I expected. And let's take a look at what we have left over. We got the casing, the nozzle is kind of still intact. And it was really cool because we were able to see it burn through all of the stages. And one thing I did notice is when it got right around to this portion of the stage, it started burning more violently and producing more thrust. You could even see the stand kind of get pushed over. And then it hit the ejection stage and made a lot of smoke and some other stuff. This was really a fun project for me. It was definitely challenging from an engineering standpoint to figure out how I was gonna make this whole thing transparent. And I thought it was gonna blow up. It actually held together. So that being said, I appreciate everybody's suggestions for this episode that I've incorporated. And yeah, keep them coming. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Check out our other videos and tell us what you think in the comments below. See you in the next video. Alrighty, here goes my see-through engine. 3 horsepower Briggs running with my turbocharger. A little primary turbocharger from the Mercedes, and check this out.